How are you? I'm very happy, proud to present you this book in two editions for alto and for soprano and tenor. It is a transcription of the Goldberg Variationen from Johann Sebastian Bach. And it's not a good idea to transcribe Goldberg Variationen for one instrument, because the Goldberg Variationen are very polyphonic, are a masterpiece of polyphony. And the polyphony doesn't work well with a solo instrument. If you think at Brother Jacob, when the first voice or flute make the second sentence, a second start with, and when the first flute or singer arrive at the third sentence, the second is doing, and the third is doing all together, and you cannot with one flute, with one instrument, you cannot make three voices, two voices. So, or you play just the melody, but it's a canon very strange if you play just the melody, or you can, you try to play some part from this, some part from this, but it's not a good idea. And why I did this transcription? Why did I do? For two reasons. The first is that you play recorder or flute and not keyboard, you will never play Goldberg Variation. And in this way you can play 70-80% of the music of the Goldberg, as if it's 50%, and this music is wonderful. And second, probably playing with your instrument this music, you will be interested in knowing better and understand better the piece. When I recorded all these 30 variations with alto, I was happy, it's a very good music. So I think that in this book the Goldberg variations are a little massacrated. But this is a book of wonderful music. I will play today with tenor and not with alto, because it's the same key, the same tonality of the original score, G major. It has been very easy to make the first aria. Because the melody is wonderful and I just put the melody for the instrument. But the Goldberg variation are not variation of a melody, are variation, like all the variation, of an harmony. This harmony and this bass, but especially this harmony, is what Bach used for making the variation. First 8 bar, after. So pay attention when you listen the Goldberg variation. You will not recognize the variation of this melody. Pam pa 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 pa. No, it's not Van Eyck. Van Eyck make variation of a melody. Bach, as Mozart, as Beethoven, make variation of an harmony. Okay, the first variation has been not difficult to be transcribed for solo flute, because there is this melody, this passed from one hand to the other. So I just decided which hand I have to put on the flute. Some melody did from the right hand, it be made for the left hand, in the bar 5, for example. Etc. And what happened in the second part, there is some section with the arpeggio. So the for flute is very has been easy to make a transcription. Because it's polyphonic and there is three voices in the original score, the bass, the alto, etc., and the soprano. All together, if I am able, and making the transcription, I take some part from one voice, from another voice. The project of the Goldberg Variation is a canon. When you have Brother Jacob, you have a canon in unisono. So the first voice starts with C, D, E. And when the second voice make E, F, G, the first make C, D, E. This is canon al unisono. So the second voice starts with the same note. What is this? A voice make a melody, and in this point, second part, the second voice starts with exactly the same melody. And there is a bass, the third voice. I just take something from the first, the second, and sometimes from the third. Fourth variation, variation number four, is not a canon. There is normally a canon and something else. A canon and something else. The variation number four is a structure on the three voices, like a jig. Choose just some part. Another thing, I have to stop my recording, and then because sometimes the computer make strange. I hope the computer will not lost all my speech. I forget to tell you something why I did this transcription, because our way of listening, the what happened here you have something timpano in Italian, I don't know the English name, that move when they receive the vibration, but this move just left and right, it cannot transmit in our brain just one melody, not two, because it is monodic. So when we listen something, we listen a very complex melody that it's all inside first. Second, when we remember something, we don't remember an harmony, a counterpoint, we remember a melody. When we remember the air, pam pa para bam pa pom pa ba. Why? Because of our way of remembering, of singing, on whistling or something else is monodic. So also in a canon, pa ra 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 ra. We remember a music in a monodical way, also a complex music. All our memory is monodic. Also, if we remember a fugue, really we remember a melody, a complex melody. So, for this reason, also I transcribe this piece. Variation number five. Now we have as a canon. No, it's not a canon. There is a canon and two free pieces. It's a very lovely piece, variation number five, in which the left hand go below and up of the right hand. It's not easy. Uffa. So you have a right hand, and the left, of course with the flute you cannot make this. I think that they just transcribed the right hand, the melody. It's wonderful music. I don't understand why the recorder player cannot play this only because it's polyphonic. Variation number six. Canone alla seconda. This is incredible, of an incredible difficulty. You can imagine like Bruder Jacob. But the second voice we start Bruder Jakob, a second higher, Of course, the first voice has to make something higher for going together, like this. But the second voice will do this invented part higher, and the first has to go higher and higher and higher and higher to make a canon alla seconda. It's incredibly difficult, and Bach solved the question in an incredible way. This is the first and the second. And with the bass andante. I think only Bach could make something like this. It's not easy to be played. Absolutely incredible. What is my solution? It's one of the thousand solutions that is possible. Variation number 7 is like a jig. Pam 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 pam. Two voices with this bass. All together. Because I just need to make the melody, to put the melody. Perfect alone. Number 9,
is Carmine at the third. We come back and Brother Jacob. C, D, E. And the second voice starts with E, but E major. It's a little complicated if you want to make a third perfect. Or E, F, G. And the second voice starts with. That's implied that it's very complicated to make a canon of the terza. Here, the terza is lower. So, first voice C, D, E. Second voice. But we will listen back. First voice. Second voice, lower. And together with the bass. I will try to make just the beginning, not easy. This has been not easy to be transcribed, etc. etc. 10 minutes, I will stop my record. Variation number 10 is a fugue, fughetta, at four voice. Second voice. Third voice. Short fuga. Of course, with an instrument you cannot make four voices, so I just put some part from. I think this music is wonderful. With, without, it's incredible. Variation number 11, I like it very much. It's a two part in 12/16. Crossing from the hand. It is for two keyboard, so the hand can go here. With the one keyboard, it's very difficult the finger put together. And this is the transcription for recorder. I don't have
have C sharp, so I make C natural. I could make C sharp, but it's a little complicated, not for this recording. Variation number 12 canone alla quarta. So one voice, Bruder Jacob, start with C, C, D, E, and the second voice start a quarta lower, G, A, E. And the second voice. Bach doesn't write Bruder Jacob. Bruder Jacob write this. Oh, not only. The answer is not only a fourth lower, but it is like a mirror, opposite. The first voice make. The answer is. The first voice make. And the second voice make opposite. The question is, how many people recognize this, listening this music? One each 10,000? But it is wonderful also if you don't, if you understand nothing. It's a wonderful music. If you understand, you can put find some data. It's interesting. Not easy for the player. This canon and what is opposite, but the music is wonderful, and the transcription, of course, lost a lot of things, but it's a good music. Variation 13, one of my preferred. It's a wonderful, wonderful melody with the accompaniment. Because the melody stop on the fifth note, but in this point the bass make boom boom, so I did boom boom in the flute. The variation third, so long lesson. Variation number 14 is with the hand
that make this. This in this case is the right hand. The left hand make harmony.
Transcription. Number 15. Canone alla quinta. So the first voice starting with G. I'm sorry, G minor. And the second voice start with D, but go in opposite direction. It's incredible. It's incredible. If you think of Bruder Jakob, it's like the first voice and the second. Start fifth higher and go in opposite direction. I try to make the beginning, but it's not easy. It's in G minor. The Goldberg variations are in G major. Some variations are in G minor. In the opposite direction. This is the transcription. Okay, we Yeah, variation 17, it's very strange, like variation. There is a part of the two, one of the two hand that makes some third. Etc. In the first part is going up, in the second part is going down. And one part is completely different. All together, not easy to be played. And then the hand, the crossing the hand, because it's made for two keyboards. And my transcription, of course, cannot make both voice, make just one. But in some part, I put the third or the sixth like this. A good exercise. The variation number 18, it's a canon at the sixth, so if the first note is C, Do, the canon, the sixth higher, start with an A. In this case, the melody and the second voice are very near, after just half note. This is the melody. And the answer arrived immediately. And after. And there is a bass part, of course. What is this canon at the sixth, etc. This is my transcription. With answer, question and answer in the 16th of distance. Variation number 19, it's a little complicated, three voices. One is this. One is this. And one is this, the third. All together. With one instrument I have to decide what I have to do, and I put this. Etc. Variation number 20, very difficult for flute and for keyboard. Both hands are in alternating. Two clavier, two keyboards, so you have to cross the hand. One make and the second make the same but in contratempo. And all together, not easy. One in controtempo and one in tempo. Of course, with an instrument you cannot do it. And put the attention of the controtempo. And then there is the triolet. And then there is the passage, very difficult. I record it, so I play it with alto, but it's not easy. Variation 21 in minor, canone at the seventh. So if Brother Jacob C D E, the answer is B C D. The answer has nothing to do with the question. It's incredible. I think it's quite impossible. Bach wrote it in G minor, and look what is right here. With bass. Transcription. I think it's a good one for music, also for solo flute. Variation 22 is a fugue at four voice. No, it's a piece at four voice. Like a fugue and three voice upon one bass. This is the bass. And this is the subject of the fugue. And this is the second voice. And this is the third. Not a fugue, it's like a counterpoint with one thematic idea. This is quite impossible to be transcribed for one instrument, but I try to do it. It's with the two hands that going in parallelo. The first start with B, the second start with B. The problem is to put all together. In which there is a B chord alternating. With one keyboard it's very difficult. I don't know how the pianist could do it with harps chord with two keyboard. And this is the transcription. There is this boo 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 boo, it's skip it. I try to find a way for making these. Etc. It's not easy, this transcription. 24. I like it. It's very singing. It is a canone all'ottava. And finally, a canone easy. It's not difficult to make a canone all'ottava. Of course, Bach make a masterpiece. And the octava is lower. And at this point, start. With the bass. And this is the transcription. Etc. And the variation number 25, my preferred one, it's a long piece that Goldberg played so slow in a wonderful way, in which there is a bass like a concerto italiano. Easy to make the transcription because they just put the melody. We are arrived at the end. 27 is a canon at the ninth. So, Brother Jacob, C, D, E.
Not easy.
And what did Bach? Made the canon in between just the two hands. So left hand start before and the right hand start after. Nine notes higher. Solo flute, it's difficult to make a canon. Okay. 28. Oh my god. Not 20. I put the 28 in another page for the changing the movement of the page. I thought that I did a great mistake. 28, it's very difficult. There is a bass. There is a melody. Alternating with this, and this is what happened. I'm sorry, I have to calculate how many before the end of the first part. So, it's not easy for the keyboard, it's not easy for the recorder too. Etc. And now, variation 29. Oof. This is incredible, it's a really piece for keyboard with chord. Look what right back. Chord, alternating with chord. So this is my transcription. Number 13, Quod Libet, is a play, is a joke.
Bach used two melody, very popular melody, very strange text, not really so serious. I don't remember which one, but it is a joke. And then the second melody is and the third is the bass. So it's very complicated. I think Bach finished with a very very complicated, but in the same time like a joke with a melody. In this period was famous but very popular. Of course, with one instrument. After the variation number 13, in the book of Bach, there is again the aria. We know nothing is changed. So, you come back. And of course, it's the same for the flute. Okay, I hope it has been interesting for you. For me, it's been a pleasure to make this transcription. Bye-bye.